is the comparison between various types of transmission line. So various types of transmission line means here we are going for your lossless transmission line, we are going for your distortionless transmission line, and we are going for your low loss transmission line. Okay, so what are the conditions? Say suppose what are the conditions for all these? Okay, if you are seeing, this is the table that is showing the summary of all these. Okay, so condition for your lossless is R is equal to G is equal to 0. For your distortionless, it is your R by G is equal to L by C. And in case of your low loss, R is much more less than omega L and G is much more less than omega C. Okay, so these are the condition for your lossless, distortionless and low loss. Now let us go for finding the different parameters. Say suppose if you are going for the propagation constant, we are knowing that propagation constant gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta, and that is equal to your square root of R plus j omega L into G plus j omega C. And similarly, if you are going for the characteristic impedance, we are knowing that characteristic impedance Z naught is equal to square root of R plus j omega L by G plus j omega C. So suppose if you are knowing that these two, we can go for finding all these parameters. Okay, so attenuation constant in case of a load, in case of a lossless, it is 0. In case of a distortionless, it is your square root of RG. And in case of your low loss, it will be R by 2 square root of C by L plus G by 2 square root of L by C. These we are getting it by substituting these two conditions in the propagation constant and the characteristics constant. Now, if you are going for the base constant beta will be your 2 pi by lambda. Okay, so that will be your omega root LC in case of your lossless. So you are having the base constant same for all the three conditions we are seeing. You will have the phase constant all will be in the same only. Next, you are going to the velocity of propagation. So velocity of propagation is your omega by beta. So as beta is common for all, omega by beta will also be same only. So velocity of propagation you are having 1 by square root of LC. So you are having for all conditions. Next, we are having the characteristic impedance Z naught. So characteristic impedance will be your square root of L by C in case of your lossless. In case of your distortionless, it will be a square root of L by C or square root of R by G. Both you can have, anyone you can have. And in case of your low loss, it will be square root of L by C. Next, we are knowing that your characteristic impedance Z naught is equal to R naught plus J X naught. R naught is the real part of your characteristic impedance and your X naught is the imaginary part of your characteristic impedance. So in case of your lossless transmission line, your R naught will be equal to your square root of L by C and your X naught will be 0. In case of your distortionless, your R naught will be square root of R by G or square root of L by C, and your Z naught will be your X naught will be your 0. And similarly, when you are going for your low loss transmission line, their R naught is equal to square root of L by C and your X naught is 0. So if we are seeing this also, this real part and imaginary part, this is also similar only. And your characteristic impedance, this also will be your similar. Okay, so you are having the phase constant similar, you are having velocity propagation similar, characteristic impedance similar, and your R naught and X naught also similar in different types of your transmission line.